Hey guys, it's Boots, and today I'm going to be playing a little bit of Dark Souls again. Basically, I got so far into the other playthrough with just the longsword, and I was thinking, why am I still using the longsword? And I couldn't be bothered respeccing into something, so I just decided to start a new character. Hopefully I can do a bit better this time. Now that I've actually done a few test runs, you might have noticed I've got the Demon's Greathammer, which took me a while to get. I don't even know if it's worth it, but it costs 46 strength, I think, to use, and it's powerful. But I don't know whether it'll be worth it in the long run, because by the time I get to 46 strength, there might be other weapons that do more damage, have better move sets. But I wouldn't recommend trying to fight that Simon Demon. Basically, you have to beat him with just your fist the first time you meet him, and it is. Let's just have a little look. So this guy's a cleric. He wants to keep his distance. Okay. He doesn't mean anything ill by it. He just yeah, go on. Okay. I'll join your covenant. So Petrus of Furland is here. I'm not sure why he's here. Or where is Jaffia? Shrug. Ah, I see. So, there's a young lady making her pilgrimage to this land. I think pilgrimage means to leave home and make your way in the world. I might be wrong about that. But, yeah, she's going on a pilgrimage, and he is one of her defenders. There's actually two more defenders that we will meet later on, including her. And we've missed out one character, or two characters actually. The Firekeeper, who we'll be meeting soon, and the, what's his name? The Crestfallen Knight. So, we're just going to do a quick run through here. This is how I always start the game. Saying that, I don't normally go around here and pick up these items. I normally just grab the item on the ledge and run off. Just jump past him by accident. Oh, hello. Okay, and we're out of here. There's the crow that carried me here. How you doing, buddy? We'll be meeting him later on as well. Well, we've already met him, actually. But we'll be talking to him later on. Or he'll be doing something to us. I don't know why I'm being cryptic about it. He's gonna pick us up and take us back to the asylum. Same thing he did. Yeah, so that's the Crestfallen Knight. He tells us there's two bells to be rung. What? I don't know why it bloody throws like that then. One in the Undead Church above, and one in Blighttown below. And she can reinforce our Estus flask, which we will be doing. It's always. I don't know why I always do it, but I think it helps a bit. It can't hurt anyways, unless you lose these 2,356 souls that I've got. So I'm going to have my Homeward Bones ready, because there's a very good chance I could die here and not get the Firekeeper soul. And then have to come back down here, which I don't want to do. And if I do have to do it, I'll probably pause it, pause the recording, and let you guys watch. Now, there is a guy back there who's a sorcerer, but I don't need any sorceries, and I can't. And he also upgrades weapons. I don't need any sorceries. That's an S stock up there, I think, which I don't want. I'll be going for the claymore, I think, and stuff. Got past all this. So you can actually beat these ghosts here, but there's little point. You get about 200 souls, maybe, for beating each one. I think I had about 2,960 souls last time I came here, and I didn't beat these two guys. But what I'm trying to do is not get hit by them, which isn't happening. So what I'm gonna do, run across here, grab this firekeeper's soul and get the hell out of here. Go, go, go. I'm dead, okay. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Maybe if I'd have killed the other two guys, I might have a chance to do it. Well, that's 2,000 souls down the drain. I can't say that I'm that displeased about it. But we'll see. Okay, let's go. Let's just get on with it. We've got the Firekeeper Soul anyway, so let's go and upgrade our Estus Flask. I could actually go to the forest at this point and get the Grass Crest Shield, but I don't think it's worth it. And there's a Silver Knight there, or a Black Knight, with a halberd. And he's pretty tough. I don't think I've ever fought him with unupgraded weapons. Normally, I just stab him in the back and knock him off the edge. But it's quite easy going through this with the battle axe. Oh. It does break people's guard as well. And there's a longsword. Do I? I'm tempted. There's a ring over there, which is a rare ring of sacrifice, and I said it in the Sen's Fortress video that I don't think I've ever used one. Okay. So, here we go again. Kill this rat. Hello, rat. Oh, hello. Okay, I'm poisoned. That's not good. I don't want to die here. Okay. Whew, epic battle. Don't have any purple moss clumps at the moment, so we're just gonna have to deal with the poison. A rat never usually attacks you. Or at least he's slow to attack. Let's beat these guys in submission. Heal up. That's a good job. That first bonfire is kindled, because I would have run out of Estus Flask. Now, well, right. Now we're gonna run out here, kill these guys. Hanging out. Kill that guy. Kill that guy. Get some rubbish. Now that will be useful. Never. Okay. You might be able to give it to the crow. I'm not sure.
Sparkly.
That's the Demon Souls crow, I think. That does it. Right, let's go. Hello, dragon. Okay, we've got a few guys to deal with here. That's not good. That's not good at all. Okay, that poison lasts for so long. So down here is an NPC that you can kill to get the Uchi Katana. But I don't think I want the Uchi Katana. Come on, buddy, hit me. Stop trying to hit me and hit me. Come on, buddy. Nice. Oh, I was just about to explain there that my controller wire is broken. So if I just like adjust myself in my seat, my controller will disconnect and reconnect. So yeah, this guy's got an Uchi Katana. I don't think I'm gonna kill him because I am gonna go for Claymore and not the. I'm going for strength weapons and not dexterity weapons. Believe you need 14 strength and 14 dexterity to wield the Uchi Katana. Okay, thanks, mate. You just told me to go and fall off a cliff, which I probably will do. So thanks for that, mate. How did that not hit them? Getting done in by the little guys. That second hit was just to make sure he was dead because I panicked. Really don't want to start the playthrough by getting killed by Hollow. Right. Now we will go to the bonfire. Should have reversed Hollowing. Yep. Definitely should have done that. But here we're going to use two humanity and kindle this bonfire because we'll be using it a lot. Or at least we'll be using it more than once. And let's spend my souls as well. Okay, so I'm human. I've spent all my souls. I haven't spent them yet, but I'm going to level up, and strength is a good idea. Can I go to 20? I'm going to go to 20, and the next time we. Got invaded yesterday, and the guy I was fighting the Black Knight with. The Black Knight with the Ultra Greatsword on top of the tower, and the guy came in halfway through the fight and backstabbed me whilst I was fighting that thing, and then taunted like he'd done something great. Like, I killed you whilst you were fighting one of the hardest enemies in the game at this point. Well done. That Black Knight could have done me in on all his own. To be fair, I did make the first strike, because I was fighting the Black Knight, and I backstabbed the Black Knight, and the guy was just stood there, so I thought, I'll get a quick little backstabber in him. It didn't do my very much damage to it. I think it did about 50 damage to the guy. And he was not impressed by that. Okay. That done. Actually, a funny thing happened. I had a summon guy in there and was fighting that Black Knight. And he just he fell off the top of the tower. And as he was running back up, I knocked the Black Knight off the top of the tower. I didn't even know you could do that, but it killed him pretty well. I'll say that. I go for it. Oh. Let's see if we can get this perfectly. Oh, that's not perfect. I'm dead. That was an idiot move. Why did I do that? So parrying, not my strong suit. Humanize, wasting all my humanity. I'm only humanizing, so I might get invaded. That'd be good. Okay. I'm gonna take that head wrap it off in a minute because it looks silly. My braided, beautiful red hair. Okay. Don't need to go in there. Okay, that was tracking. So, I'm not sure if this is exactly right, but I think the main problem with Dark Souls 2 is that in this, the enemies track and then attack. In Dark Souls 2, they seem to track and attack at exactly the same time, so very hard to dodge attacks unless you use your iframes properly. Okay, that should have backstabbed him. I'm stuck in that animation though. Okay. I always seem to do it whenever it's a long wind-up attack. I always seem to parry just before I'm supposed to. I'll never get that backstab either. Alright, come on, buddy. Attack. Attack. He's gonna shoot and stab me through the wall, I knew it. Thank you. is terrible. This is terrible. I just need to calm down a minute. Oh, I did it again. Is it a long wind-up attacks? They get me every time. I've got no health to fight the boss. Right, I got you. Hopefully I won't need any health to fight the boss though. Get down. Get down. See, I actually pressed left trigger at exactly the same time that he hit me. Guess that's how you do it. So I always expect there to be a little bit of a delay between the left trigger and the parry. But it seems, as soon as you hit the left trigger, that's the moment when it parries. I think that's what I've been getting wrong. I've been expecting it to parry a second after I press the left trigger button. Or the left trigger, as most people call it, and bloody hell. I didn't expect him to hit me then either. Right, one Estus Blask. Let's make it count. We're gonna beat him anyways, no problem. So, Twinkling Titanite. It's not what I would have hoped for, but I'll take it. I'm up here. Hello everyone. I'll tell you something, I'm not. I'm not jumping down because I'll just lose all my health. Oh, come on, just die. I'm sure I did damage to him before he fell off. He must have healed up or something. Not even equipped. Going to use Gold Pine Resin here. It helps an awful lot. Actually, in a test run yesterday, I dropped on his head and landed on this little banister here. And then after I'd done the drop attack damage to him, I ended up doing another drop attack by accident because I dropped off the ledge. Oh my god. This is so powerful. Oh, you're not dead. Alright, sorry. He stepped on me. Mistimed the use of the Gold Pine Resin there. I equipped it so I could use it before he appeared, but then I walked forward and triggered him. So we've got 6,000 souls. That doesn't matter. Because we're going to see Solaire. A grossly incandescent sun. Okay. This is the biggest challenge in the game. Yes! I didn't press no for once. I always skip through the dialogue and press no, and then I have to sit through another bit of dialogue. Oh, grossly incandescent. So he's given us a white sign soapstone, which helps us be summoned into other people's worlds. I've actually worked out how to get past this guy now. Turns out running underneath his legs is not the best idea. Have to run around him. There's no items outside that door. nor there's no point in going outside that door. Just there. I'm gonna kill myself. Yeah. I'm just gonna quickly use this large cell of lost and dead and level up. So the claymore, I'm not sure how much damage it does. I know how much damage it does. I'm not sure how much strength you need to wield it. So, we'll see. There's no chance of us beating the gargoyles in this video. I'm just gonna go out here and wait for him to jump down. Stand here. But don't stand too close to the edge when he fires the fire, because he will burn you. They can't kindle that bonfire, do they? Yep. And this bonfire can be kindled as well. Okay. You got me once, I'll give you that. Goodbye. Okay, let's go and kill these guys. Hopefully I don't go too far out and trigger the dragon. That was bloody weird. I want this sword. Thank you. I wasn't even in danger of getting hit there, but I parried it. At least I don't think I was in danger of getting hit. So let's go claymore. Unable to wield this weapon effectively. I can't even dual wield it. Okay. Let's just have a look at this weapon then. Guessing its dexterity is down. Yeah, I need 10 dexterity. Only needed 16 strength to wield it. Let's hope that's enough to level up. Probably not. It is, my god. There we go. Well, let's go up here. This is where I get invaded yesterday. Let's not go over. That's Kendall. Why not? Okay. So we're gonna go through this entire area and get to the blacksmith. Let's go and fight this guy. I don't think you've even ever actually seen me fight this guy because I just ignored him last time. He's tough. Good slice there. I really don't. Okay, I got stuck. I really don't want to risk a parry. See, Dark Souls is fair, but when it glitches, it's not. And you might think I'm just being a whiner, or a moaning ass, but right there, I tried to roll to the right, which I couldn't do, and then he hit me and knocked me down. But whilst I was getting back up, he was already attacking. And the attack hit me as soon as I was ready to move. So I didn't even have a chance to dodge or block. So I'm going to fight this guy. But I am going to wait until I've beaten him to reverse hollow him. That does a steady amount of damage, that's good. Okay. I really hate his moveset. It's really hard to judge exactly what he's going to do. And when he does do it, even if you're blocking, sometimes it can just kill you. Just die. Okay. Take that chunk. So we've fought two Black Knights, got no weapons from them. I did get the Black Knight Halberd yesterday, which was nice, but I don't think I used it. Yeah, don't heal up. Frame rate is excellent. Okay, on to the other spear guy. Can't be shot whilst I'm doing this. Right, last time I used Alluring Skulls to get the guy into the fire down there. This time, I'm gonna stab him in the butt if I can. Thank you. Right, tighten that shot, nice. Missed his butt. There we go. So that's two solutions for this guy. Stab him in the butt. Get in close, because his close range attacks are really easy to dodge. Very much like the pigs in Bloodborne. Nobody attacked me. Okay. Bloody hell. Oh my god. Great, I think we'll leave it there for this episode, guys. Next episode, we'll be defeating the gargoyles and hopefully making our way into the forest to save a beautiful butterfly from living forever. Okay, see you guys in a bit.